Yeah, you can always tell when someone's on the cell phone because they'll be going right along 50 or 60 miles an hour, whatever the speed limit is, and all of a sudden they'll drop down to 40, 30, 20. And then the conversation picks up again and they start picking up the speed.
Representative Laura Pantelakos has pushed for a stricter cell phone ban in the past, but it didn't fly. She hopes things will be different this year.
So if this bill were to pass, when you get into your car and start it up, if you don't have a hands-free set, you're going to have to take your phone and put it away.
I guess I'm okay with it, because I really do see some bad stuff out there with people swerving on their cell phones. Do you ever drive holding the phone to your ear?
Yeah, on the occasion, yeah. But, I mean, I personally don't like doing that. So if somebody calls me and I'm in the car, I say, like, I'll call you later. I will answer it.
If you got caught talking and holding the phone, you'd get a $100 fine. The way the bill is written now, the police officer could go as far as searching your phone for proof.
Weird. I don't like that.
There was talk of that, but I believe that's been taken out, Heather, or it will be in committee.
Attorney Mark Stevens believes if that part stays in, the bill would be unconstitutional.
Police can't just take things from us and look at them without a warrant.
He also believes the ban itself isn't necessary.
If they're not doing anything else wrong, if they're driving normally and they've got a phone up next to their ear, they're driving, obeying the speed limit, maintaining lane control, there's no reason for it.
It's a safety issue, and they put it in many states, and I think it's time it came to the state of New Hampshire. And I know they're going to call it a nanny bill, but I'm a nanny, and I love that word.
Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.